So, you know, we've been coming here since 99. And one of the things which has always been important to us is where will we place our elders so we know they're safe, so that we know they have good proper shelter, so that we know that they are protected in the way that they offer us shelter and protection with their wisdom and their knowledge and their gifts. And as the dance has grown, and as we have gotten older in the dance, you know, we are shifting, we are aging, and our needs are growing here. And so for many years, we have placed our elders in Garden House and two structures behind it, Altaria and 14, I believe. And in the years that I've been coming, in the years that I've been the vision keeper, I just sort of keep walking by, and I love seeing the elders sitting on the back porch and having a good time and having people fix meals for them. But I always get a little nervous, antsy about the garden house and those stairs that are there. And so last year, when I was here, we had this moment where there was an elder coming down the stairs, and the elder slipped. And luckily, everything was okay. You know, we were protected here. But it could have gone another way. And that would have been a different story. So we were blessed. But that was just one more indication to me that we needed to move. We needed to do something different. We needed to create new places. As our dance is growing and we're expanding, we need to grow as well here in this land and in a respectful way. And so Jeff, the bundle keeper, we had been talking about, you know, it'd be great if we could have some cabins there, something that are there, sort of a seasonal place that we could build, and we could have our elders and people with special needs stay there. They can be warm and dry and safe. And so we talked about it, and we're like, okay, we're going to do it. And they're like, all right, so we need to raise money. And my fear flag totally went up. You know, I was like, money? I have no idea how to raise money. We're never going to raise money. Like, how much does it cost? And, you know, Badger was like, oh, he came up with some designs. And he was like, oh, it might be like $15,000. And I was like, $15,000? Mm-hmm. Like, how is that ever going to happen? It's not going to happen. And so we put out the call last year here. And here we are a year later, and here they are. Like somehow, right? I know how. But it's happened, right? The abundance of the people, this community, has helped provide this gift. This is a gift to the land, it is a gift to the ceremony, and it is a give back to our elders. It really is. It's such a blessing and honor to be here. I was so honored to work with Badger during this process as he drew up these designs, which were so magical. And to see them on paper, where it's just this drawing, and then to see the manifestation of the drawing is more than any dream I've ever had about how something could be. It's such a blessing. And to hear everyone come on this land and be in awe of them. People love them already. They're already well loved. And this is just our first dance using them. So I know that they will just be filled with love and beauty and power throughout the time here. And also, as well, Badger also built stairs on the side of the garden house. Safe stairs, right? Nice. Beautiful. Safe stairs. He said, oh, it'll be really easy. I'm just going to, you know, put some stairs up there. And I was like, I don't know how that is going to work at all. And there it is again. So, you know, first of all, Badger, my hat is off to you. Oh. You make me proud to say that I know you and love you. And so thank you for sharing your gifts with us and for these people. And so I thought, you know, Clyde and might like to say a word, if maybe a few other people say words, and then we could just have the cabin smudged out. And B has invited us to walk through this cabin here. So I thought we could smudge this one here. Grandma Janet has agreed to do that. Maybe Clyde, if you could help us smudge out that one, and then, you know, we could all walk through.
Mm. Will they be named?
Benson, you are a mind reader.
I thought I was in trouble.
Yeah.
So yes, it's nice to have a building that has a name. You know, it sort of sets it, stakes it there. And so I was thinking, I don't know how we're going to do this. I don't know what names to do.
I can come up with the Polish version.
Well, you can tame it.
17 syllables.
Please. So here are the names that came to me one day when I was with the Buffalo Skull. Mm. They just came. And I just was like, well, those don't seem like good names, but they haven't left me. So I thought we would call them Sage and Cedar.
Yeah. Should we say it three times each
time? Sure,
one?
please.
Sage. Cedar.
I wanted to get them little plaques.
Yeah.
Clyde is a mind reader because I was like, now they need little plaques.
Uh-huh.
Exactly. So, Badger, I don't know if you'd like to say a word or two.
Sure.
Please.
Sure. This has been a long-standing prayer of mine, one, to give back to Nominus and to give back to this land. Because I found my way to the fairies many years ago, and they basically saved my life from a life of anger and shame and guilt. And then they led me to my Naraya family. And so that was a long-standing prayer, too, to give back to my Naraya family. So I was really happy to be approached with this project through the elders to give back. I was able to knock out two birds with one stone and felt really good, and I knew it was really right and really special. They went up really good. Really well. I was, I've built hundreds and hundreds of living spaces through the years, but these went up really well. And I was guided and directed by ancestors that are here on this land. I felt their presence really strong. Sometimes I get ahead of myself in the construction project. I think it through a little, sometimes too far, and I forget maybe a relevant task that I need to perform to get to that end result. And all of a sudden, I'd be in one of those awkward moments, and all of a sudden I would feel ancestor say, Badger, what do you think, you know? So you don't have to go back and, you know, fix it. And so I'd say, oh, thank you, you know, thank you very much. So that was a really beautiful process. So I was very much blessed that way, and I was supported in a really good way by the community through all of your prayers and your well wishes. I was supported really good while I was here on the land. I was taken really good care of by the stewards of the land. I was fed and made comfortable and had a nice, dry, safe place to sleep. The last gathering that we came off of, the Beltane gathering, all the boys and girls came in wrote on the inside of the wall cavities all around their prayers and their songs and sweet little messages about the land, little satchels of beautiful plant medicine was placed in the four corners, and it was really lovely, really beautiful.
These cabins are a manifestation of bringing a dream or vision into reality. And like you said, Rosette, these were just merely a dream. It takes somebody that knows how to use the tools mm-hmm. and how to bring that into this world. Not all people are just have a talent for just the spirit or that kind of thing. There's people that do things and build things in this world, such as our friend Badger here. I have great admiration for Badger mm-hmm. because I myself am not a carpenter. Mm. I'm one of those kind of people that I put a nail in the wall and it automatically bends on the second hammer.
Yeah.
One time I was so proud of myself, I framed a window. And I was real proud of myself because I did it by myself. Mm. And here he builds a whole house. Mm. You know, so that's wonderful. And a lot of this manifestation was bringing these cabins into reality was through the heartfelt efforts of people, each and one of you, whether it be $25 or $5 or $10, it was contributed a lot of it through the NCPC, which is the philanthropic arm of these Narayas. You know, we had a special fund specifically for these cabins. We're happy to do this, and in the future, speaking as the director of the NCPC, there's hopes and dreams and visions for two more mm-hmm. these cabins, and hopefully in the future we will have two more lovely structures like this. It'll be back further on the other side of Garden House, I believe. And then hopefully these cabins will be well taken care of and loved and will be kept to their purpose. And that not only we Naraya people, elders, can use them, but also elders at other gatherings. Mm-hmm. It'll be a great blessing all around to this community and to the fairy community here at Wolf Creek to have these structures here. So that's what I'd like to say. Mm-hmm. Bless you all for helping out.
I mean, to me, and I think to a lot of us, these cabins really speak to the good heartfelt friendship between the Naraya and Wolf Creek all these years, and how solid both groups feel in our relationship with each other. You know, there was never any hesitation about making this sort of mutual commitment mm-hmm. and accepting this amazing gift. We've been going through a process of a lot of internal upheaval and change and blossoming, but it hasn't really led us in a direction of doing a lot of building lately. And so the timing is really nice that at the same time that flowering is happening in other ways, these buildings sprout on our land mm-hmm. as an expression of love. And mm-hmm. you know, let this be another piece of new beginning here.
Yes.
An example for future buildings.
And you all held the space so well mm-hmm. during those calls. Like, you made them fun, you made them informative. I learned so much about the land, about the process of consensus, about what it takes to turn something from paper to this material tangible item, this shelter. I mean, and it was such a blessing because I got to speak with you all on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. I felt like our intimacy grew. Mm-hmm. And just the whole process of coming from the idea to this. Mm-hmm. So I want to thank you all for holding the land so well and with such intention and about really approaching this process with openness. Mm-hmm. May I enter or do you want to carry?
You may come in. You gotta see how you took care of us. You know, our clothes hanging instead of laying in a lump.
Which is kind of nice not to have your clothes laying in a lump, you know? And because I'm an old ornery Indian lady who does not dress in front of people, that I'm supposed to not do that. They even put me up a curtain. Mm. And I sleep on my buffalo robe.
Good.
And it comforts my heart, just like this place does. But you thought of everything, I gotta tell you. And we are grateful. And to you, too. To all of you. who made this possible.
It's our pleasure.
We lift you up. The Makah people have a saying that my grandfather, who was Makah elders, that every ceremony is, we lift you up. We lift you up. And that's what we're supposed to do for each other. Mm-hmm. And we're going to continue that.
Mm. I mean, it was magical.
It's beautiful. And you know, we don't have a problem with people coming in and looking at all. No. And even look at this. You got to see. A special place for that horn bonnet where it's safe and protected. He didn't even know that he supplied that. But there it is. Mm. So he took care of everything.
Will there be a hot tub?
I'm hoping.
It's a little close.
The only one I get a chair and
we get a back porch and a front porch.
We are so spoiled.
Wow.
I love that we all have the same.
That's right.
This is our sage saloon.
Oh, is that right?
I've been coming to Wolf Creek since the first dance in 99. In fact, I was here in 75, even before it became nominous. And I've, over the years, it's gotten harder and harder to camp out, and I've had some really bad nights of cold. And this time, I've had two amazingly wonderful nights of sleep. It's been warm, there's been no draft. It's just been a really, really wonderful experience. I am just so grateful. And I can just feel my ability to give back so much stronger because I'm not dealing with the physical problems of being here.